chasing status. King Push, D-Boy, Dark Side, Stash Money, Archive, R.I.P. Nigga, that's me, nigga, that's all eyes. Seeing me with them hoes, seeing me in them clothes. I'm settled in, I'm setting trends, they TMZ in my pose. Doors up, hard top, money cash, that's hard knock. Life file, this lifestyle, I'm documenting it right now. Good music, God level, goes hard for the whole gang. All white, everything, my hands dirty with cocaine. Joke a smile on that front end. Fist 10, my sit 12. You ain't talking no thick hoes. If you like me, that's two niggas and six bitches in tight clothes. More money, more problems. My toe don't mean much. All gold, everything. Not Trinidad, nigga. King Tut, King Push, Kilo. I'm the voice of it. CeeLo, machine gun, Steve-O. It's just as big as my ego. Rah!
In my veins, and my heart feels no more pain. I know I'll be on my way to heaven's door. I know when I'm not, I'll be hoping I don't drop to a place where I will rise like before.
Fuck you.
When my mind stops thinking and my eyes stop blinking,
bleeding and my lungs stop breathing in it. I hope somebody cares.
When the blood dries in my veins and my heart feels no more pain, I know I'll be on my way to heaven's door.
Ocean.
Ketamine. Ocean.
Welcome, sword and board nerds, warbanders of all ages, genders, races, to Warband Battlestream! Tonight we have the beautiful match Legends vs. Saracen, and I will be joined by the most handsome of the two twins, probably most famous warband twins there are, Deacon and Cleric, and I've got Deacon. What's up, Deacon?
Hello, you alright? Good to see you again.
Yeah, not like I don't see you every day.
Not like we don't play with each other every day, but our streaming personas haven't met for a long time.
Exactly. It's a shame, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, should be a good match anyway.
Yeah, Legend Saracen, you know. On MBTV, there's also, I think it's Core Westward.
Yeah, make sure you check it out. Have both up at the same time. Obviously, watch, listen to us, but watch them both at the same time. Why not? Core versus Westward. We're in the this is the final stage of the group stages, where so it's the losers' final. So each team that wins these matches, there's also Teutonic versus Espia, which I'm afraid isn't being streamed, but each team which wins this match will make it into the quarterfinals, and the team that loses will be eliminated. So everything riding on these matches really should make them pretty exciting.
Yeah. Also, if you do, you know, want to get in touch with Lust, make sure you tweet at him at Captain Lust. But if you do, and you want to give him a signal, you want to give some appreciation to my lovely friend Wadley, make sure you do hashtag Wadley. It's very important. It's very important. I just got some news for Carpe Diem. He's still waiting for some of his players, but. Both teams have enough players in the server, so we should be ready to go pretty soon.
Saracens were looking a bit thin on the ground, but most of their the big hitters have arrived now. I was a bit worried.
Sebek, Habrak, Barbarian, Virus,
Artisan. I mean, we were talking about the match a bit beforehand, and I think one of the major talking points is obviously going to be Peter and Toby.
Yeah, for sure. And we both know how good, you know, both players are, especially Peter, probably one of the best, if not the best player in the world, for a long time, so.
Yep, and Toby, I mean, he's a...
Yeah, we all, Toby's super
he's
famous.
He's more famous for his dueling, no doubt, but he's a very accomplished battle player who can, clutch out with it.
Very good in Gavin and melee as well, you know.
Yeah, and it's just that kind of... They are a factor, don't they?
Yeah,
they're
and also...
Not just a skill factor, but like a bit of a fear factor for a lot of teams, I think.
We shouldn't look at them as being Peter, and then Toby. They're Peter and Toby, you know, they play together, they're good friends, you know, they've got this chemistry when they play both Gav, you know, I mean, it's very interesting and nice to see, so, yeah.
Yeah, I think that's the major talking point. I know there was a bit salty Bohemian were after losing to Legend after, because it didn't look... I mean, Peter and Toby played for Legend in the WNL, and they did very well. So I don't think it's entirely fair to just be like, oh, why are they being able to play for them? I mean, they've had a history together, so...
It's not like Legend doesn't have any, you know, good players next to...
They have plenty of good players.
Yeah, plenty of good players, you know.
But I understand why Bohemian might have been a bit disappointed. I mean, most people were predicting them to win, and then Peter and Toby turn up, and...
Yeah.
Whilst it must be very easy to be in the mindset, well, we would have won if they hadn't played, blah blah blah.
But also, I would like to point out, as you can see on my screen right now, this is a bit of a modified version of Mountain Fortress. It's not the one we had in the last WNL season, so it's not that old, is it, this map? So I don't know if both teams have enough competitive experience with it yet.
This version of the map is brand new. Like this is the first time this version of the map's been played competitively.
Yeah.
So
we'll see if both teams have had enough practice. You know, it's mostly the outside wall that has been changed a lot, where there used to be like a long ladder. Now it's more this open platform thingy.
Yeah, the changes were made in the direction of trying to make it more like a closed map, because it was a bit more confused before you had these wide open spaces, and it should play. I think we had one scrim on it. Unfortunately, we don't get to play it competitively, but we did have one scrim on it, and it was. Seemed a lot more open. There's a lot more infantry engagements and stuff like that.
Yeah, exactly. There's a lot more archer spots as well now, except for just the wall and the entrance. Now there's a lot more angles that archers can work with, and the platform obviously is more accessible for Gav as well than just a wall, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
It allows for more combat, basically. It's more flexible,
well,
the map.
The wall made it very, very difficult for the attackers to make any kind of headway at times, didn't it?
Yeah. I also feel that the part like at the back where you can come from the defender spawn with the stairs, and the little carpet over there, it's more valid as well now, because it wasn't really used before, you know, the change to the map, let's say. Now you can actually, you know, now it's actually a valid position. Alright.
I cannot see any... we were talking about him earlier, I forgot his name again.
Sorry, it's a bit of a dream.
The former ref cavalry player.
Dominique, of course.
I cannot see him, and I'm a little bit worried for SLC if he's not here.
Yeah, we were talking about that earlier, how destructive that Peter and Toby can be, you know, as a calf duo. And they were saying, yeah, you know, Ref obviously don't have anyone who can, you know, match those two in skill because they're just like the top of the world in it. But we said that, you know, a former Ref player, Dominique, was the kind of player that could, you know, sort of outplay and outskill and like outsmart a lot of calf, but not like directly head on fight them, you know, just sort of shut
Yeah.
them down a bit.
Well, we saw it against RNGD actually in SoC versus Renegades, and skill-wise, I don't think he's as good as like Pierre. I don't think he's as good as Sakichi, but he's clever enough and he's talented enough that he can shut down like key players like that, and that is so vital against players like Pierre who can tear holes in teams. Like to have like a Cav player who's just gonna get on his back. Constantly stop him like fighting, constantly stop him getting these couch lances. I mean, what a difference that would make. That would put SRC in the driver's seat.
Well,
And
but
I
we
don't know if he's
also
using an ult, but I cannot see him here.
nah. So that's gonna be it's gonna be something. No, what we also said is that we think there's one major point in which Legend is outclassed and outplayed by Saracens, and that's gonna be, you know, the ranged part. The players like Virus here and you know, even Sebek and Abrek, you know, they're also very good shots.
Prince 17, who is
Yeah.
going under the name White Wolf. I'm not
White Wolf,
100% sure
cool.
why. But oof, I mean those two are
Yeah.
like despicable, to be
Come
honest.
on,
I
yeah.
hate fighting
We
them.
saw that in
Like,
the Renegades for Saracens match, how much they, you know, put effort in for the team, how much they made entry frags, how much they opened up the entire map, the entire, you know, match for the team even, you know.
yeah, just scrimming with them. I mean,
Yeah.
what a difference it. And they're two players who are willing to, they don't mind like getting into a bit of a weird place and like trying to pick off like a sneaky headshot. They're not afraid of moving about the map on
On the
their
other hand, they're
own.
also very solid in melee. Like they won't just it's not like you reach them, they die. Virus is also a dangerous melee player, and
Yeah,
so is
particularly
Prince.
Virus. I mean, Prince
Yeah.
is no slouch, but Virus is
It's good, you
Virus
know.
could
Yeah.
you could
Yeah.
happily play Virus as an infantry and do fine. Yeah, so I'd say they have the advantage there, but once again, Legend have some very nice shots
Yeah,
with like
indeed.
people like Caius and even Paolo himself is a pretty nice shot, so they have the advantage, but yeah, once again, Legend no slouches.
Carpe Diem, give a little shout out to Anders. Anders, if you're watching, I know you are. You know, Carpe Diem loves you.
Infantry, I mean, who would you give the advantage in this? It's
Oh,
kind of,
it's hard. It's
it is
hard.
hard, isn't it?
I think these infantry fights will come down to a ranged support and gav support on both sides. So, you know,
What I have
that's good.
seen, I mean, what I have seen, Habrak and Sebek particularly, when they're playing well as
Yeah.
infantry together, and they don't always play infantry because often they play cav or sometimes they play archer, but when those two play infantry together for SRC, it always feels like that's when they're at their most solid because they have like a have two like really nice like
Yeah,
infantry like
you
solid
talked about
infantry
the
players who can
chemistry
work
between
against
Peter
each
and Dolby, and like, there's also this chemistry between Habrek and Sebek. You know, they just work together. Like they just play the game like as if they were standing, you know, sitting next to each other. And
Yeah, definitely.
it's really, really fun to see.
Interesting recruit there for Legend, we can see in spec. Black Angel.
Yeah, indeed.
That's a thing
He's
that
not French, is
surprises.
he?
He's certainly not French. That's definitely a surprise to me. Formerly of Heroes, and then I think he briefly joined Inquisition, and apparently he's left Inquisition now and he's playing for Legend and he's a very good infantry player. I just wonder, I don't know if there's going to be some kind of language barrier, but I have no idea. But good player. I mean, if they can sort out any language problems, then he's a great recruit.
Indeed.
He's a really nice infantry player.
Very solid.
Yeah, it could help them out a lot.
So, there's this map, yeah, Rodok Fagers, and then what's the different map? I think it's Village, or
Oh,
what
no,
other
because
maps?
I was thinking of the quarterfinal.
Okay.
I'll have a look.
Because I would say this map, Mountain Fortress, is pretty balanced with Rodok defending, Vigor attacking. Seems like an okay balanced map with the changes, you know.
Yeah, I'm
There's
looking
no
forward to see
real
how
like
that.
faction imbalance as we had on Snowy Village with Rodok Nord, you know.
Okay, so it's River and Village, Nords versus Swadia.
Okay, that's fair enough. It's gonna be
I think,
well, okay,
well,
that's
I
fair.
mean, that's kind of interesting
Yeah.
because, I mean, Rebrand is one of these open maps that have have the ability. It's got enough like cover and stuff like that that infantry players can do something. So maybe Nords could pull out a few surprises here if you're seeing a load of Nord.
We've been talking about the Rodok, the Swadian snowball effect. You know how if they win a round, they can get like super good armor and stuff. But you know these Nord axes you can get, they can you know put a stop to it at basically any point. So it's not like there's any real imbalance there.
Yeah, you get hit in the head with an axe.
You're gonna get damage, man. You know, come on. No bounces there.
You can get one shot. Yeah,
exactly.
I have a feeling Carpe is hoping one or two of his other players are going to turn up. And I'm going to laugh if Dominique turns up. Oh, nope, they're restarting on live. Slightly from that.
There you go.
Not live.
Let's say are we not live, so I guess that's pretty okay. It seems Legend will start out as well.
Yep, and I presume this is going to be the team for Saracens then. Carpe Diem, Red Bull Snuff, Skeechy Arthazan. I assume Arthazan's going to be playing Cav.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah, Virus. I can see him playing Gaffert now to get up with Carpe.
I don't think they'll play T-Chat. I think Carpe will go. Although he's looking like he's taking proper equipment.
If they attack the open side, it could actually work out. Like, the new renewed piece of the map is so open that you actually could work.
Especially now you've lost the wall. I mean, there's less safe positions for archers, isn't there? And
everything's more opened up, as we said, more flexible, so yeah.
One second.
If this
one
is minute. The... Don't worry. If this is the setup, then we can see a pretty, you know... I think it's that's four infantry watchers and two cav. That's quite an interesting setup on this map. I wouldn't have went for that. Wouldn't have predicted that to be this way, but yeah. Let's watch how dangerous Virus is in the game. Restart on life. Here we go, guys. Don't have any side panels, no mini map, no special headlines. This is pretty much old fashioned WNL mod. Good luck, have fun to both teams. Let's take a look at this. Alright, two cav, I saw, and that's two crossbows, four imp for our Rodok team, for our Legend team. On the other side, you have at least Carpe as a cav, and that is. That's in total three archers, two infantry. No, three archers, three infantry, two cav. That's good. Fair enough setup for both teams here. So let's take a look what they were doing. It seems like Saracens are looking for an opening at the main gate right now. Legend are being quite defensive, not pushing up all the way to the main gate and to the side alley here, but let's take a look at the camera. Alright, Saracens are moving in right now, a little bit inside. Habrik looking for an opening here. Okay, let's take a look at this open place, see how both teams are set up here. Okay, one crossbow there, one infantry as well. That's pretty good. Question is, where are Saracens going to decide, you know, to push? Are they going to decide to push this side, whether it's two crossbows to win, or are they going to go more
User
towards
joined
the open
your channel.
Platform? Who joined the platform? Yes. Take a look.
User was moved out of your channel.
Sorry about that.
Piero just joined the channel. Sorry guys for that. That was a.
Hey, wake up!
Oh my god, he's poking me. Goddamn fucking Piero, man.
All right. Is this? Oh, it started. Oh my god.
Yeah, it started, man. It's live right now. You're way too slow.
Group B losers final.
So yeah, excuses for no streamer mod again because this is a little bit messed up. It's nice if you can see names. You never realize what you're missing.
Okay, outside. That kind of route sets it back to zero, really, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. I mean, Legend are already on it, though. Don't keep in mind, guys, Legend are Rodok, so Legend already have a flag with one infantry, one crossbow there as well.
Yeah. I wonder. I think the big thing's going to be is Caius is going to be in a nice position. Other than that, I don't think getting there early is going to make too big a difference. I'm sorry, they have left the crossbowmen over at the castle as well. They have got a nice position. It's going to be difficult for...
Here comes the infantry, though. Saracens infantry, Barbarian leading the charge here. We're going to try moving in, seeing if they can get something done. Gav comes as well.
Okay,
so
they're doing a nice
doing it out there. A nice shot coming in there.
Oh, lovely.
That's important.
And
gets a bump stab in as well. Oh, but Jean comes in and gets something done
like
as well.
Some of the SLC guys were overextending there.
Yeah, well, they didn't push as a whole. We saw Sebek here hanging back a bit, and, you know. But now it's Saracen, so yeah.
Still to play for, but these archers are going to have to get stuck in if they're going to win. Nice there. Sebek goes down and Rodolf.
Flag is up, man. Flag is up. No problem for Legend. They just hold the flag till it's done. So you can see Artisan gets a bump kill, but Saracen's players do go down in the end. Only 3 survive. Only 2 kills were made.
SLC were a bit... they weren't confident at all in their push, were they? They needed a plan, and if they didn't have a plan, I feel like they should have gone through the castle, really.
To the open platform, breaking up the crossfire.
Exactly, I mean, you break down any crossfire that they could have if you take that wall area.
Yeah, we saw the Saracens infantry pushing on the flag as well, and immediately one got shot on the shoulder over the shield. I mean, that's pretty depressing, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's just... Like, you shouldn't be... They sent, for example, Barbarian went to try and kill Caius in that ruin, but he was never going to be able to make it, and he didn't. And like, there was no cohesion in their push, really, was there? I wonder if that 2 cav. I do wonder about that, to be honest. Although Legend have 2 cav as well, so
it was one of the cav from Saracens though who did get the 2 kills that they made. So beautiful couch there and bump. So yeah,
it's quite amusing that Peter and Toby are playing cav actually.
Yeah. So these are Elts then. Who's Jean and who is... Let's take a look.
Jean... I believe Jean is Toby, but I'm not 100% sure. It's all speculation in reality, because obviously none of you have seen the IDs, so make of it what you will.
Yeah.
It's not guaranteed to be him, but...
Flag's in 20 seconds out, or 23 right now. It spawns the same side. I would like to see Saracens do something different than go outside all the way. Because it just takes so much time, man, you know. Flag was already halfway raised when they got there.
Maybe leave someone hide here and then send the rest around. When they were walking into a crossfire, and if you push through that, like the castle area, you break down their crossfire so easily. And then all they have is that back ruin area, which is good, but not so great when it's getting shot.
In fact, this spawn the same time. You see Caius and Erenion making the same move again. Caius going into ruin, Erenion on flags with his war spear.
SRC going in the same direction. I wonder. So obviously they have some confidence. We'll see. I would have thought they should be... Okay, yeah. They're pushing
slow.
With much more confidence this time.
Yeah.
But the flag is halfway up now. They need to watch out because...
This is a better position, but that one crossbow can be annoying over there.
But
there comes the couch. There, it is communicated. Let's just take 2 quick kills here. Paolo gets a nice shot off.
Paolo. We didn't do our predictions, by the way. Who do you think's going to
win? Look at this first. Legend just mopping up Saracens here.
Annihilation.
Yeah, one player left on flags here. He's going to get stunned. There he goes. Get shot on the end by Cookie, picking up a double there.
Once again, it's difficult to kind of judge how much that was to do with... I mean, Saracens never looked comfortable moving into that position once more. I mean, they were a bit more...
They were more together, I guess, but then, once the engagement came, they just collapsed, they fell apart, and that was that, you know.
Yeah, I feel like they need to take a few firing positions first, like move through the castle.
Saracens are changing it up. They're taking 3 archers now, 4 infantry, and only 1 cav, so that's a change.
That's probably wise.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, Shikichi Alphazen was doing some nice work, but I just felt like attacking these positions. It looks like Saracens are going right for it. I think that's a really good idea.
Yeah, it is. There's already 1 crossbow and 1 infantry position at the ruins, though, and 1 crossbow infantry over there, and 1 crossbow on top.
They need to be more confident if they...
Yeah, they need to go. They need to, if they want to make this work, they have to push. Yeah.
Legend still don't have the infantry to kind of stop them pushing, though. I mean, Russians could try and clear out this kind of left ruin in front of them, on their left, but... I mean, they don't seem to have the confidence in them.
No.
Okay, they've gone through the right ruin now. They've taken it over. And now the flag's going to swarm on the other side of the map, isn't it?
For sure, man. That's the way this game works, isn't it? But look at that. With that inf there and that crossbow, there's not too much they can do right here.
Yeah,
they've got the ruin, so what?
They nullified it. So, I mean, if the flag does spawn here, they'll be happy. But...
It's a 1 out of 3 chance, though. I mean.
Yeah. I'd like to have seen him go through the village. I mean, nice.
Barbarian goes down. Is Barbarian calf player? No, he was infantry. Didn't see his corpse.
Though. And that's really bad. You don't want to be losing players to couch lances like that. But that does highlight the danger factor of Peter, doesn't it, really? He's always trying some kind of crazy couch lance, and a fight breaks out. Iranian.
Whatever, mate. Virus takes out John. That's a calf down. That's a warhorse down. That's big. That's really big.
Especially if the, they're fighting out, and Sebek's in a really dangerous position. Needs reinforcements right now. Goes down to Paolo. Ooh, and Carpe Diem
goes down as well.
Good money after bad, and Chris Lewis takes out a horse.
A bit of fight here. It's a 2v1 though. It's a 2v1, and there goes White Wolf.
Arthasan takes out Peter.
Okay, that's Peter and Thornby gone, you know. But four players in exchange for two. That's not okay. And where's the flag? The flag is not yet being raised, I think. No, it's not. But people are going there right now for Legend. So yeah.
SRC have an opportunity here though. Legend have split up far too much. If SRC move in and try and punish them now,
but they've been so comfortable around this position, you know, are they gonna have the balls to do it right now? Or be like, yeah, let's go for it.
They need to do something soon because
like it's being raised right now.
They have cav. The enemy don't have cav. They should really be pushing this advantage. It's a warhorse.
Perhaps,
like
perhaps the
war
cav. Yeah, that's a good choice as well.
Oh, takes the hit, but that's probably worth it anyway. And now, let's
look at this. Virus is a bit in trouble though. Here comes the calf. Can he do something? Virus is going to try taking a shot here.
This is what I mean. Legend has split up far too much. They're accepting like 1v1s. Yeah,
Virus takes out Paolo. Gets taken out though. A bit
Virus
too greedy there.
Down. That's a big kill.
So you can see Arthasan needs to make. He gets stopped there. He needs to make something happen here.
Really needs to pick up a kill. I think this is too late.
Oh, maybe not. If they need to get on the flag right now though.
30 seconds left.
Flag is, they got some time left, but they need to get this player off flag to at least get someone on it.
Arthasan needs to get this bump stab off. He really needs to get this done soon.
Come on, get something done here. They need it. Good movement here from Forax. Gets buffed there, goes down. Flag. Guy who stakes out Habrek, that's a 1v2.
Arthasan needs to go and kill him now. Arthasan can't let him get to the flag.
Does he realize that? He takes out a war spear.
Here we go. You can't let him get to the flag.
It's close. That's a bump off, not a stab though. There goes Roddick. Roddick take it just by guy who's getting on the flag there when it was high and the time was done. Roddick take it.
A lack of urgency from Arthasan there. He really needs to get in there and kill him.
I guess he did manage to save the warhorse, so they can take this round, and if they play a good defender side, then that's good.
Yeah, I mean, I think that was a bit of.
Well, it's. We're not seeing a lot of confidence here from Saracens, you know? They do push, they do attack. Yeah, Legends seem confident enough to do all these things.
But a lack of that was tactical naivety. They split up. They had a big advantage and they split up. And they allowed, I mean, whenever you have an advantage, the one thing you don't want to do is have a 1v1 fight. Because why would you? You can lose that advantage. You don't want to have a 2v2, you want to have. You only take fights where you have an advantage, and they spread out and they lost too many men and. Have a feeling SRC in the coming rounds, they really could take advantage if Legend continue making decisions like that.
Legend also, they all seem pretty beefed up still. Some panic cloths, some ragged outfits, some nice helmets there, so they're not going to be hurting on that front. And Saracens, they're still stuck with the, you know, bad shields, with the not so good armor. I mean, some clean kite shields here for the archers, they can in theory shoot through that, you know, pretty comfortably.
Yeah, this doesn't happen often though, does it?
Oh. It's these small things though that you know, a plain kite shield will break fast, and a kite shield in a group melee fight that might matter.
Oh,
but Gaius,
what a shot!
Proving his worth, man. Look all the way over there. He takes out, you know, Sekisi Arthasan, which I think was the only cav on a warhorse with the nice arm over there. That was a beautiful shot.
And that is massive. And we were talking about the Saracens ranges before the game.
Not game coming out right now. It's not coming out, is it?
Not at all. I mean, Virus has done a few things, but. Not enough.
Nah, there's no, you know, possibility here for the Saracen archers to do that much.
Whilst Paolo, particularly Paolo, but Gaius has been doing some
look
nice work.
Look at that shot from Gaius. It might just seem one kill and it gets his score up to 3-1, but, you know, we cannot, you know, say how much that's important. Gaius takes out Virus! God. Whatever, Gaius, man. He's like, whatever, I do it, whatever.
And Xbox? I mean, any idiot who says Legend are like a two-man team, I mean, look at them. Like, Kaius putting him.
Yeah, we saw Peter and Toby getting taken out last round very fast, but still, you know, Legend managed to win it. You know, it was close, obviously, but did it.
And here they go, this tense standoff on the flag. SLC need to pick up some early kills here.
SLC are not going for it, though. Here comes the Gav, here comes Golui. No, just a good fight there. Oh, Quani Throw picks up a kill.
They have got an extra cav then. Did we know?
Yeah, they did seem to do that. We didn't see that.
And they're trading equally, but that trading equally is not good enough for SLC.
It's a 2v5 right now. I mean, the trade is over. It's going to be 4-0 for Legend. Very convincing, even.
SLC looked better in the closing rounds, but I mean, really, Kaius, you don't want to be dropping too much.
Kaius picking up a third this round, you know, gets the forward, why not? 4 kills for Kaius, and giving him a 7-1 score. I mean, just 2 shots. That's big, man, that's big.
Really big. What round? I mean, that was Kaius' round, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was completely, you know. First taking out, you know, the Grav on the Warhorse, then taking out Virus, who we said was so important. And 2 kills in melee, you know, supporting his teammates. That's good, isn't it?
I mean, that is the opposite of what I think people would have been expecting. I mean, Kaius, everyone rates Kaius, don't get me wrong, but Virus is, like, the hot archer in Europe at the moment. Like,
yeah.
I mean, no offense.
Oh, no, I'm taken. I know
but, but Kaius just banging him out in an archer duel. I'm not even sure if it was an archer, we just sniped him.
He just sniped him, I think, yeah. Like, and that just shows that perhaps there's a bit of stress on the Saracen side, you know. I mean, 3 rounds in a row, you know, you're paying attention, talking to your team, what can we do when you get shot in the head? I mean, that cannot feel good, but, you know, kind of.
We'll see, you know. I mean, it looked to me like having a crossbow was an advantage in the fights that were happening.
Yeah.
So maybe SLC, and I know Virus is probably better with a crossbow. Prince probably is good with arrows and crossbows, but Virus with a crossbow should be a bit more dangerous. We'll see, though. I mean, would you say, I'd say Rodok's had a slight advantage.
Yeah, they do. I mean, they're a very defensive faction. You can still play very defensive on this map, so that's good. I'm probably getting a nice shot there, though. I don't know, perhaps Legend put in, like, a lot of work for this match, you know? Like, hey, we want to continue our ECS story. We don't want to stop right now. You know, we're going to play for it.
Yeah, I think many people had them written off after they lost against Bohemian.
Yeah.
But did really well to come back. Who did they lose their first match to? Legend.
I'm not sure.
Legend lost to Saracens. Must have been, wasn't it? No, it was RNG versus Saracens, and then Legend versus Bohemian.
Oh, yeah. Bohemian won that then, or? No, I think Legend won that, and then they lost to.
Okay, so Legend lost to. Oh!
Confusing.
Considering I'm running this tournament, you'd think I'd know a little bit.
Yeah, even asking before the stream.
Saracens actually beat Legend 10-6.
Oh, this is a bit of a grudge match here.
Then Saracens obviously lost to Renegades, and then Legend beat Bohemian very comfortably.
Yeah.
Here we are with the rematch of the week 1 fixture.
Anyways, we see 2 crossbows so far and 4 infantry. Okay, 3 crossbows, 4 infantry for our Saracen friends. What can we see on the Legend side? 1 archer, 2 archer, 2 archers, 4 infantry, and I'm guessing 2 Gav, Peter Toby.
I think from Saracens, that's pretty standard.
Pretty standard, yeah.
Maybe 1 less crossbow is the standard at the moment, but just like hitting
pretty
all the
infantry on Vegas, though, for Legend.
So. I like that. Looks like they're going to be playing it aggressively.
Yeah, I think that could work out for them here.
Yeah.
Have to see.
I think they want to come in here though, because Habrak.
Yeah, has a nice score on it. Here comes a bit of Gav as well.
Ooh,
he's a crossbow.
You don't want to get shot in the head there.
But if you can shut him down.
And I think they allowed that to get shut down much too easily. Now Habrak's stuck.
He's gonna die. There's no way he can make it out. The fight continues though. Artisan gets a kill.
They're committing a lot of people to this. And it's
he's staying alive for a long time here. That's good. Here comes Gav to support as well. Can't make anything happen just yet. Right.
They've committed far too many people to killing Habrak. It's just not worth it.
They're missing stuns right now. They're missing stuns. He's still alive. I'm trying to stun with a war spear here. Right, there he goes finally. But it's a 4-man trade now just for Habrak now with that team kill coming in. That's just too much, isn't it? Okay, Artisan gets a team kill in.
Doesn't matter because Prince is putting in a little bit of work. Toa picks up 2 kills.
Oh, it's a 3v3 right now. 3v3.
Here we
go. But all the 3 players are shut down in here. I mean, They got two crossbows. If they play this smart, they can still win this. Both teams can still win this. The shield is broken there. Ooh, Varus, very dangerous game here. Like, three 1v1s going on. I'm going to try to catch from all of them.
Carpet picks up the kill on Kaius. The others should really be playing passively right now.
They cannot lose right now. This would be Varus lovely picks up Dota. There's so many cookie and left right now. A team hit happens?
Matter though, because
lag there.
Carpe Diem leading from the front, a warrior king.
Four kills, you know.
But I mean, who was your? I think the real MVP of that round was Habrek.
Yeah. He didn't do anything. He didn't get any kills, but he stayed alive for so long. And there was at 1.4 people trying to kill him. I mean,
is why you stun shields.
Yeah, that is why. And if you miss them, if you start team hitting with them, you know, that's a sign that the team has not been, you know, practicing on team play enough, or it was a stress situation.
Like, three people to kill one person and have it last longer than like 10 seconds, because then you're left with.
Gonna go for it again though, they're aggressive again, they're gonna try shutting him down again. Can Havrek do this as well again? He's gonna get some Sebek support right now.
Now their person sent to shut down the crossfires, outnumbered.
Prepare takes it first. Wow, kills coming in from Saracens all over the place. Both Gav are down for Legend here. Oh, they have one Gav left.
Nice Bahrainian, picks up Sebek, Bahrainian goes down.
He picks out Havrek though, there goes Cookie as well. Killing here, just trading here.
I can't see them losing this.
Dismounted.
Jean.
The
Jean
guy is having a 1v1 versus hammered. Virus on the platform here. Virus takes it. It's nothing.
Virus is taking two 1v1s against Kaius now, and that gets to you. Losing 1v1s to the same person, doesn't it? It's annoying. We'll see. I think this has got to dent their confidence a little bit, Legend.
Yeah. Look, they're changing it up as well. Like, okay, we're not going to play aggressive. We're going to go outside. We're going to play defensive. I mean,
that's really good to see, actually. Both teams have been happy to change things up. It didn't work out for Saracens last round.
It's a sign of a good team, isn't it? Being able to, you know, seeing your mistakes.
Yeah, you need that kind of confidence. So often you'll see people just sink to like a 4-0 defeat, and it's a bit depressing.
What can we do?
Yeah, exactly.
Saracens, they're having a good read though. They're getting up platform right now, and like, nah, we know what you're gonna do.
Yeah, they don't have that rune though, so it's gonna be harder to hold. So it looks like Saracens are actually looking to cut them off. I like this by Saracens.
I'm not sure I like this too much. There's one archer there as well. They could get cut out here. They shouldn't overcommit here.
Paolo takes a hit. Carpe versus Paolo. The two leaders find it out.
Alright, takes a bump. So there's some calf support. Forex takes out Sebek. And Carpe is no longer in a 1v1 right now. He's getting some cabin there as well. Jean takes out Barbarian. I don't like this push up. They overextended, I
pushed
think.
Pushed out far too far, didn't they? Yeah.
And they've given another one.
Yeah, they just split off into a place. They got kited.
Yeah. Hard. Kited. Simple as that. Just White Wolf, you know, Prince left right now.
A bit, probably got a bit happy, didn't they, after those two wins? Got a bit overconfident. Yeah. And
we can take these guys. It's a clean round.
Yeah. Leaves Legend with a definite advantage going into the second map, but we'll see how that plays out. SLC are going to really want to pick up the next round, otherwise.
Yeah, if they can win this, like it's going to be 5-3, and 5-3 is, you know, the difference between 5-3 and 6-2 is just big, man. Just big.
Yeah, it's very big. Of an error there though, I think you're right, Saracens kind of, they got overconfident, I think. It's the only reason I can think to justify it, because they're playing a very kind of passive game, letting Legend come onto them and then battering them.
It also worked for Legend on the other side, so.
Yeah. It's nice to see an attempt at a bit of aggression, but it was disorganized, wasn't it?
You can take the outside for a bit, Saracen's not really contesting it. That's fine.
I don't think that matters too much, but looks like Carpe's headed down there with a virus. Interesting kind of symmetrical splits from both teams, isn't it?
Yeah.
And here they come. And yeah, it looks like Legend are just going to give it up. That's fair enough.
That's okay. They don't have to do this. I think that perhaps this archer might be a bit good at now. Nah, nobody's going to push Kaius there.
Oh, virus. Oh.
Showing what he can do in it. Just a clean headshot.
Why is an infantry dying there? Why is the infantry not behind the wall? That's the kind of, like, that should
happen. Yeah, but that's also just a great shot to make, though. Like, you wouldn't expect
that's a brilliant
shot.
Yeah. It's a great shot, but if you're an infantry not doing anything on a closed map, you should be hiding behind a wall where nobody can see you. You shouldn't be milling about.
Guys, if you want to talk about this match, again, you know, tweet at Captain Lost hashtag Wobbly.
Yeah, tweet Captain Lust, who happens to be commenting on a completely different match. I'm sure we'll love that.
Just the hashtag Wobbly is important.
Okay, now, Saracen, suddenly their move to occupy that ruin area looks like a great idea. But Legend are doing what I said in the first set, and they are going to take that wall, which should give them a much better chance.
Yeah, it should. But look at the flag, it's going up pretty fast with Dream 50 on there, if you can get good positions.
Actually, getting onto that flag is going to be a nightmare. And here comes the cab!
Oh man, that shouldn't happen. The cab is stopped though. He's going to dismount, he's going to die as well, he should die. Another cav. Oh! Misses the couch even.
I don't think that's a good trade for Legend.
No.
I don't
think Legend should not have done that.
Well, I don't think it was a question of Legend doing it, I think it's Peter being Peter.
Well, yeah. Peter being Peter. The other cav gets stopped as well, that's pretty bad. Nice! Wow. Saracen's overextending there.
Fire's putting in absolute work. It's 3v5 now.
Guy's taking out Corpid Diem there.
Ryan goes down to Virus.
Oh, White Wolf takes out Dota. It's a 3v2, 3v2. 1v3. Can Virus do this? Can he become really big for his teammate? He needs it.
Needed that to go through. Nice chamber there. But he's won this 1v1 on two occasions so far.
This would make Gaius' day though if he could just beat Virus right now. Oh!
Ooh, that's huge.
30 seconds. You know, they need to make this 2v1.
Toby needs to go for it.
This is smart though. Turning Dermot into a smart play.
I preferred what they're doing before, to be honest. It's gonna be difficult. They're two solid players. I'd actually prefer it if. If Toby was fighting in there. Looks like they're just going to play this passively, which is the right thing to do, I think.
Oh! They get a hit in though, so he's almost dead. They know it.
It's too late, it's too late.
They go to Ithacus anyway. That's a 2-2 then, bring the score to 6-2 and a body kick as well, coming in.
Always like to see the body kick. Nice bit of...
It's a ball of tail words, you know, everybody who kicks corpses is just, you know, we all know it. He's awesome, you know.
Yeah, obviously like...
Not a village idiot at all.
Like all arrogant people like myself, we love body kicking. I'm a big fan of body kicking. I think it's a
really good thing
to do. I think it's a good thing to do. I think it's funny. It immediately makes you a funny person.
Without Deacon, without that. So 6-2 going in. I don't think this is what, you know, Saracen's expected to find. Make more happen on this side, this map. It is a pretty new map, let's be honest. I mean, perhaps they didn't have so much experience with charging in and stuff. And
but, I mean, John and
just say Toby Peter.
looked in pretty good form, so aren't they going to look in even better form now?
Yeah. Legend certainly, you know, sort of being a bit, you know, not bragging, just impressing us a bit with how many players they've got there. Dens playing in 4 more in spec, it's quite a big roster, isn't it?
Yeah, they've always had a pretty big roster.
By the way, you should, okay, lock the team members view, that's cool.
I'm not sure if I can see Saracen's winning from him. Mm-hmm.
I think you should at least, you know, put up a good fight, I hope.
I certainly wouldn't write off.
I don't know, I feel...
I don't know if they're going to be able to keep up with the Legend camp.
I just feel they're a bit inconsistent against Saracens. Like, they had this period in WNL3 where they were so good, you know, they were like actually a threat to everyone. And then at the end of the WNL3, they just fell apart a bit. They're like, yeah, I don't know, something happened and didn't play that good. And now they played very good against Renegades. They played, you know, 7-9. They did not win, but they played very good, you know, seeing as how Renegades is probably, you know, a very top team. But then they played in Warband Weekend Cup finals. Well, not the semifinals. And they lost to ORB, or the Rising People, 14-2. I think, you know, that's gotta mess with your head, man. Like, one time you play super good, and the others, you know, just can't cut it.
It's hard. They're a team that I kind of struggle to work out, to be honest. There's a few teams like that, where one moment they're absolutely fantastic, and the next moment they get have a result that you just can't understand. It doesn't make any sense.
I mean, ORB are a good heroes, team, but 14-2, like that's quite, you know, it's quite bad, 14-2. Nothing
yeah,
to say there.
Utmost respect to RP, they're a good side, yeah. But Saracen shouldn't be losing 14-2 to any team.
Exactly.
Right. Not they shouldn't be losing 14-2 to anyone, like not the best teams, not like that's just a really bad score for them, and I don't know how on earth they got it, to be honest. Having said that, Saracens looked pretty sharp, didn't they, on Snow Village against Renegades?
Yeah, they did.
Certainly their Rangers looked sharp, yeah. And their Rangers looked like they'd have the capability of shutting down people like Peter, shutting down people like Toby.
Yeah, well, it's, I think a lot of things come down here to the range play of Saracens as well. They also have Talar now, who did not play first set. He's a good Ranger, let's see if he can make a difference.
He'll be playing Cav, won't he?
Will he? I don't know, he was playing a Ranger when I saw him play against Renegades. Let's take a look, I'll do Saracens here. A lot of drops going on here, see, one Archer, two Archers, Archer, I'm not sure, three Cav at least.
We got great answers and courses for...
Okay, that's gonna be, let's see how that pans out.
Yeah, Legend Cookie's got great lance.
Well, it's not live, so no worries now.
Oh, I'm...
There's 30 players on the Legend team, mate.
I know, I wasn't paying attention. I would like to see kind of courses, I'd like to see a bit of... It's a bit of a shame when all you ever see is... Hunters and like, Heavy Lancers or whatever.
Yeah, if they can make it work, I mean, sure man, why not? The jabs are looking stronger from Saracens. Unless it's just warm up, but White Wolf, 3 kills already, 2 headshots.
Yeah, he's a player who's really come into his own of late, I think, Prince 17.
Yeah, yeah, indeed.
He's formerly Polish Eagles, and he's always done alright for Polish Eagles, but wasn't really until we joined Saracens that people started kind of sitting up and taking note, I think.
I do think Saracens is a team that are better in open maps due to the way their teamwork works. You know, the Cav and the Archers and the way the Inf plays as well, it all fits together better on open map than a close map, I feel. I couldn't really tell that about Legend. I don't know how well they play or what difference is between their open and closed map play. We'll see.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see. It is hard to kind of judge this Legend team that not long ago were pretty much written off. And have got lots of new players, lots of, like, players. I mean, look at the size, look how many players they have on right now. I mean, who knows? there's a lot of players I do know. But there's players I've heard of, but that I don't know particularly well. Like Tiger White, Forax. There's a few players, I've seen them on IG a few times, but I couldn't tell you anything about them, frankly. And that's unusual, to be honest, because usually I'm pretty on top of that kind of thing.
Alright, everybody, teams will go live pretty soon now. Restart and live.
I feel kind of. You'd have to say Swap that you were the superior faction on this map, wouldn't you? So. You'd have to say Swap that you were the superior faction on this map.
I think 3 Cav we see, and that is 4 infantry, 1 archer for Saracens. That's an interesting setup. Oh, you see 3 crossbows at least, and I think 3 Cav as well.
Yeah, 3 Cav. No great launches, but Peter and Toby are both on courses, which I personally love to see. I think that's awesome. And this is what I wanted to see from Saracens, just kind of... They've got a load of infantry, they got a load of javs, and...
They're gonna be aggressive,
man. You can make it work as Nords against... That's how you want to do it. You can... I mean, these courses... If you can throw a jab,
3 javs, man. 3 javs, that's it. Already one taken there.
Like, I mean, has someone been dismounted? No.
I guess one of the horses did get a jab in it though as well. So.
Oh, Carpe, he's in dangerous position.
He gets out though. Watch out, that horse is too close. No jabs going through Jean's horse.
That's the danger though, coming in with these calves.
Being very aggressive here, but if they make it
work. Oh, lovely jab by Carpe.
More jabs coming in as well.
If they keep, they need to keep up this push, but they need not to get split up. They're
yeah,
getting a bit
now they're getting a bit split up. Here comes the calf though. Oh, I thought it goes sick now.
It's a really nice kill.
Look at Cookie though, nice position from him over there.
Carpe gets stuck. He needs to get out of there. Nice by Legend, picking up kill.
Wow, 4 kills already for Legend. Making it work. This can still turn though.
Can still do it. Especially if you picked up that. Still, 3v4, they can still do this.
Yeah, they can still do this. 3 cav as well. So,
definitely do it now. Yeah.
Now they need to stay away and wait for flags. No, it can't be too aggressive. Right? Oh, Carpe!
Paolo goes down and Carpe leading from the front once again.
3 kills already this round.
Watch out,
he gets dismounted. He cannot die. Not a dismount. Is he gonna die? No, he's not.
Oh! 2v2.
So close. Oh, the kick misses, but no slash. No slash
he's
to follow up.
He's going to try and take out his horse with a jab, I presume, but he's missing at the moment.
And he gets it. Now he needs a crossbow.
He
now need to work to get on the crossbow.
And now John has got a bastard sword, and fighting him with a bastard sword isn't going to be particularly fun. I can tell you that for free. Alright.
I can't let him reload, though.
And he needed to get this bump set. Is he just going to keep it? And here comes a couch lance.
Oh, gets the bump. Nothing happens.
And he can't go too far. He needs to stay with him.
No, what is Squirtle doing? Flag spawns. No horse. Carpe can get this perhaps raised.
He has to harass them.
It's going a bit soon. That's true.
Is he going to go for a couch lance? Yeah, looks like it.
It's very brave, though. He's going to go for a bump slash. A bump stab them.
He's gambling.
It's a stance, but look at John picking up some jabs as well.
He just has to pick up one of these bump slashes.
Yes, and he does pick up Gaius. No. It's a 1v1 right now. He needs to harass him until the very last moment. Oh, Carpe comes up big! 5 kills!
Damn, 5 kills!
5 kills, completely turning around that 3v4 into a 1v1 and winning it!
Complete clutch and honestly, stupidity from some Legend players.
Yeah.
That's the only word for it, I'm afraid. They threw that away, frankly. Yeah, they had such a definitive advantage and brilliant.
4 kills in a row, like super fast, and then you know, Saracens
amazing
did it.
Play from Carpe Diem, but oh, Paolo! And like you do so well in a round and you lose a player like that, it's just.
Yeah,
it's messy.
It's so sad, man.
Shouldn't happen. Still, I don't think. I mean, it wasn't one of the infantry. I mean, it's bad, but. Yeah, he's playing infantry. I mean, it's bad, but it's not the biggest loss ever. Considering, do they even have any archers? I think so.
Yeah, I don't think they have, but if it's worse for them.
it could be worse. Especially if these jabs keep landing. Yeah, I thought the Saracens infantry folded far too easily, I would say that. And Legend kind of pushing into their.
They seem like they don't know what to do right now. They got a 4 infant bunker here, and they're like, okay, where do we go now? They're not here, we can't see them, where do we go?
We'll see. I think Legend are kind of. They seem to be avoiding a fight, and they're just going to wait on the flag and then try and use their jabs to take out the enemy horses. We'll see. It could work out for them. It is the kind of map where that's possible, unless the flag spawns all the way over next to that forest. Paolo's. Ooh, lovely. He gets his shield up just in time. And here they come. Is that push kind of shepherding Legend away?
Let's take a look at this from this angle.
There's all sorts of jabs flying everywhere. They want to watch out.
Flag spawn central. That's good.
Now it's Legend's move now, but Legend.
It's a gap. Can they make anything happen?
They're running straight in. My language.
Wow.
Carpe picks up a kill on Tova.
Important. Demon happens there though for some reason.
Ooh,
quick kills coming in.
A lot of team
kills happening, man. Team hits.
Yeah. Really messy play by a few of these Saracens players.
good communication there. If the cav gets his mount, he can just back get 2 free hits in there for nothing.
Half some pulls him back, but definitely not enough. And
Quantic Troll here is just gonna go down.
And we know we're gonna see a lot of these Swardins and some pretty nice armor next round.
Is this a 7?
Yeah, it's well, the last set was 6-2, wasn't it, last map? Yeah, so it's 7-3.
7-3 right now.
And
one more round and it's a forced draw? Is it the tiebreaker?
Yeah, there's kind of multiple ways they can solve the tiebreaker, but we'll go into that.
Yeah, it won't happen.
Yeah, I don't think so. I really can't see Legend losing, to be honest. We'll see though. Could still happen.
Still, like, that clutch from Corpidium should just be a highlight. Corpidium just, you know, hammering it out.
Yeah, Carpe's putting in some great work, but like a few of the Saracen's infantry did not look up to scratch at all.
So a bit more defensive play. Legend seemed to go to church, and Saracen seemed to stick at the 3 houses over there. So that's cool. That's cool.
Kind of, I agree with how Saracens were playing it. I just think a few of their infantry have been playing badly, to be honest. Because I really like what they're doing against Swardia with these jabs, with their kind of heavy infantry build, particularly against all the causes they're facing.
So, what team will the winner of this match fight to continue in ECS?
Winner of this match will fight the Guard of Astinia.
Be a good match as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, Battletech's at Carpe.
And big trouble now for SLC, who need to take at least one more round in this set to have a chance. And Carpe venting some frustration. Nothing too explicit, don't worry.
You should give him, he's a good guy.
Yeah. And
Black Spawns at church, that's basically Legend Thirst right there. I mean,
yeah, but I mean, Peter's horse is probably nearly dead. It's still got an arrow and a jab in it. I don't know if this is the best map for horses, to be honest. Yeah. I definitely understand. I can understand the advantage on, like, Field by a River, but surely there's too much cover. And Peter's going for one of his couch lances, I think. Here he comes! And he gets
it. Fires. That's important. That's basically a loss already for Saracens. Lost 2 players, lost 1 cav, one of their archers. Sky is picking up Wyvern like it's nothing. I think one of their cav gets dismounted there, but that's basically just another inf on the flags right now.
Yeah, well, dismounted Peter is still Peter, isn't it?
Stops the horse there. Kaius picking up.
I tell you what, Kaius is putting some beautiful work.
You know what they say, man. You know, Belgians, you know, the best Rangers.
I don't think anyone says that, but. I mean, the cav is doing really nicely. Like the whole team's like chipping in for Legend, whilst it seems to be only the cav doing anything for Saracens, and that's not.
So
good
this match. Is match round, yeah, for Legend.
I think so. Yeah, I mean, Saracens really need their infantry to pick up kills, because if they can continue not picking up kills, they're just game over. Yeah, this is match point. And I think most people have predicted the Saracens win, but it looks like Legend on the cusp of victory here.
Pretty convincing as well.
They certainly look the better side so far. It's not.
How do you think they will hold up against IG then?
It's so hard to predict, isn't it? This Legend side could do anything almost. Yeah. I mean, with Jean and Louis, they could spring a surprise, it would still be a surprise.
More than that, like shots that Gaius has been making all the time, Paolo as well, shooting good, their inf seems solid.
Yeah, definitely. They could pull a surprise, but like I was saying, it would still be a surprise to me.
Yeah.
IG still are going to be favourites no matter who they face.
Aww, cheers, man.
Although, if he keeps up that, then I might have to change my opinion. Yeah, they look. They are. Going out. Sebek's doomed. That looks horrible.
hard, isn't it? When you're like, you lost your shield, there's like a few crossbows shooting at you. Yeah, Paul takes him down there.
This is practically game over.
Firestellar picking one. Very unlikely, but they could in theory still do this.
They need kills. They need kills soon.
Need to stay alive mostly now. This is it, White Wolf is over.
And Saracens are out of the ECS, and the second seed go out to the third seed.
There we go. Legend
win. I messed up my seedings, man.
Right, really? Legend IG, how do you feel about that?
Wow, that's going to be a really exciting match, isn't it? I think.
Probably stream.
Yeah, definitely. Well, we'll see. But it will definitely, it's got to be streamed, doesn't it? Well, all these quarterfinals are going to be pretty exciting, and hopefully we'll be able to get more streams. But I guess they won't finish the match because they don't need to, because Legend are through. But we'll see. Commiserations to. Oh, there, it looks like they will play it. Commiserations to Saracens, though. I mean, they've been great competitors, haven't they? Even in this match, they had moments where it looked like they were going to pull through. Legend, though, really on point. Caius has looked amazing.
Yeah, indeed. They were looking all pretty amazing. Gavrip was good, perhaps a bit aggressive. I don't know if that'll pan out against any other team the way they did against Saracens, though.
I mean, man of the match?
It's hard. I'm tempted to say Caius,
We'll go with Caius. I think, definitely Caius. He is just the work he was when he got that 7-1. Carpe, honourable mentions to Carpe Diem because that was pretty impressive when he got five kills and clutched it out against two people. That was fantastic.
Yeah, that's the way, but, you know, a captain of a team should just, you know, motivate his team, you know, like, I don't care, I'll just kill everyone and then, you know, we have another shot at this, you know. It didn't work out, but kudos to him for playing good.
But Caius, really, for me.
Yeah.
I just think too much messy infantry play from Saracens. I think that's what cost them. On the open map particularly, but even on the closed map, their infantry looked a bit shaky throughout, I think. Unable to get kills, they weren't picking up like kills quickly enough. The best player in melee almost seemed to be Virus, and he's playing Ranger.
Yeah, indeed.
So I think if they want to look at what they perhaps need to improve to move forward, then they need to like solidify their infantry teamwork, which surprisingly is something they've done very well in the past. So I'm not sure what's happening there, but...
Alright guys, we're going to leave you tonight with one more song, or outro song. It's amazing. All these songs are an idea of Deacon, so go ahead and thank him. Thank you, Deacon, for all these amazing songs.
Oh, don't blame me.
Thank you for watching. I don't know if Lust is still streaming Core Westward, but if you can, certainly go check that out.
Get on it.
Yeah, get on it. Hashtag Motley, of course. See you guys next time.
Chasing status. King Push. D-Boy. Dark Side. Stash Money. Archive. R.I.P. Nigga, that's me, nigga. That's all eyes. Seeing me with them hoes. Seeing me in them clothes. I'm settled in. I'm setting trends. They TMZ in my pose. Doors up. Hard top. Money cash. That's hard knock. Life files. This lifestyle. I'm documenting it right now. Good music, God level, goes hard for the whole game. All white, everything, my hands dirty with cocaine. Dead devil, stunt man, fly nigga, you jump man, G4.
flies, we jump start with a joker smile on that front end. Fist 10, might sit 12, if you ain't talking no thick holes. If you like me, that's two niggas and six bitches in tight clothes. More money, more problems, my toe don't mean much. All gold, everything, not Trinidad, nigga King Tut. King Push, Kilo, I'm the voice of it. C-Lo, machine gun, Steve-O, it's just as big as my ego. Rah!